So in part one of this video, we cleaned the Roborock Qrevo, the actual robot. Now we're going to clean the docking station for the same Qrevo. The tools for the job here are our trusty toothbrush, a little bit of vinegar if you need it, this will be just a splash while we're cleaning, and some dish soap. Again, just a little bit of it. That's about it. Step one is going to be lifting this tray out, ideally, if you even need to. You might have some dust and debris that you might want to just shake out to get it clean. That's pretty simple. Later to put it back in, it's just like when you first install it, it simply pops in. That's it. What you're going to do now is you're going to remove this tray here. And that's it. If you'll notice when I pulled it out, there's a little hose over here that usually points right into here. So when you pull it out, the hose just kind of slides out over it. When you go to replace it, make sure that you have the hose pointing in the same spot. So if you'll notice, this is pretty dirty. That means that when we go to wash it, we're going to wash it in the sink. We're going to clean all this up and we're going to use a toothbrush to get into all the nooks and crannies. Over here, this tray, you put your finger on this tab here and push this direction, and you'll be able to take it out to further clean it better. You might want to wipe some things down over there with a wet paper towel. If you have a lot of crumbs or anything like that, you could even potentially use another vacuum cleaner to get in there. The other things that we're going to clean are the two tanks. The dirty water tank and the clean water tank. So these tanks might have some kind of a nasty buildup after some time. So we're going to clean those in the sink. What I'm going to do is I'm going to actually, the dirty water one is dirtier. I'm going to fill it up with water most of the way. Splash some vinegar in there and some soap and kind of let it sit just a little bit to kind of kill as much growth as possible. And then, of course, clean it out with a toothbrush in every spot that we can. Okay, those are the main portions there. Now, the other thing I'd like to mention before we go to clean in the sink is the filter. If it's time for you to empty the filter, just pull straight out like that. Very simple. This is the filter bag. Now, if it's time for you to replace your bag, this one is only about half full. You just pull it right out over here, as the symbol shows, and then you'd be able to get out. What's nice about this is, as you pull this out, it actually covers the little hole where the entry into this filter bag is, and then you could put a new one right in there. It's, again, very simple, very convenient. This one's not completely full yet, so I'm going to put it back because there's just not, it's not time to empty it yet, because these are not, ideally not meant to be emptied. They're just meant to be replaced. So I'm going to put it back. Push it back in all the way until you feel a little bit of a click from this top part and this bottom part. And then push. That's about it. Very simple. And then to put the cover back on, make sure Roborock is facing up and just push. Very simple. So now we're going to go to the sink and we are going to clean the base, this little base insert, and the two tanks. And one thing I'm going to make sure to also mention, if you do clean it with vinegar, don't let the vinegar remain afterwards. Make sure you give it a rinse so you don't leave any vinegar inside. You don't really want to get vinegar to get inside the system. It can cause faster rusting if you get metal components inside the housing. But again, if we're just cleaning with it and then we rinse it, there's really no reason to worry. Now we are going to put the tanks back in. Okay, I'm just going to usually let this dry fully, but for the purposes of the demonstration, I'll put it in now just so you can see how it is installed. For this little piece here, what you're going to do is the part with the black float switch that goes towards the back like this. So you move it back at an angle and then let it push in and then push until it clicks, just like that. Now we're going to put it inside here, and you really just slip the tray right in. And the only thing to really look for is that hose that's all the way in the back. You want to make sure that it sits not behind but in here like that. That's it. That's really all there is to it. If you like this video, please subscribe and feel free to put some comments down at the bottom, and I would love to respond to them. Thank you. Bye.